All right, hey collective, this your midnight snack. Now I ain't said that in a long time, have I? I'm gonna start giving y'all midnight snacks back. Now look what stayed on the deck. Now the last card was all about the emperor. I guess we're talking about the emperor's assistant now. Are you in this energy, man or woman? Oh my God, y'all. I just feel so good all of a sudden. That reading was fire. I said, Spirit, show me what cards to pull. And out of all the deck, you know, these cards can get a little cray cray. But that was lit. Oh my God. I needed to hear that one. Now let's see what's coming out these cards. I think I was guided to pull from these this time first. Let me look over there at these. Okay. I don't know. It's like Mama Gaia wanna talk to you. She wanna talk to you. And love and partnership. Now, 44 was the last card that came out. The first card that came out, the other one. Now, I think it's something about your environment that could be changing. It doesn't necessarily have to be, but I see a lot of peace within it. Love and partnerships in regards to your heart. And I've been waiting all my life. That's what I hear. Oh, Lord. Oh, Lord. Domestic harmony. Some type of completion. This is all about some type of transition. My last reading was you being accepted into the fold. I feel so silly right now. What's going on, Spirit? She said she finna show me. Something in regards to your intuition and you surrendering to something. And we're gonna take this one. And you got Spirit telling you to keep moving forward. Perseverance. Now that's 444. It's something in regards to your spiritual growth. You completed something. And I say 444 because of this. The environment. It's like move, keep moving forward. Don't slow down. It's don't stop now. Pulled from these cards in a long time. Now this is healing in regards to loving partnerships, those past busters that you used to mess with. Look like you're healing from that, boo. Now it could have something to do with your own, your personal relationships at this time as well. You know, you ain't gotta throw the baby out with the bathwater. I'm liking it. Now, anytime that I see healing, I see DNA upgrades. Yeah. Because I think it's your mind that heals the body. When you feel good, you start to... when you heal, you start to feel good. Ooh, look what's hot. In the deck. And this is going on completion. Due to some type of realization. That's you. The masculine and the feminine. Understand? You understand? That you are your twin, your light and your dark, bringing that into balance, your masculine and your feminine. Yeah, with the sacral. It's the number two. Universal love. Oh my God. Right here on personal growth. You understand, boo. And this is all about manifesting whatever your little heart desires. But the sacral. Sometimes I get the solar plexus and the sacral messed, confused. But this influences your thoughts, boundaries, intimacy, creativity, pleasure, attractions, addictions, and letting go. You know? All the hoopla and the lies that they told you, you know, the divide and conquer us. We know that this is universal love. This is about good and evil. It ain't got nothing to do with color. Now, I am just so pleased with you guys. Pleased with myself, too. Because this for me, too.
You ain't gonna leave me out. Let me see. What's going on?
Is these friends? Nope. Spirit want these. Yeah, see the high priestess. Now I actually think that I guess it really don't matter. Yeah. I don't know. Which one? Go which way? Which one is it? Alright, let's put this one here. Yeah. So this is you coming into balance in the mountains, standing your ground in regards to partnerships, but you're healing from any toxic ones. You just letting that stuff go. Now, we've seen the Empress stayed on the deck. Yeah. You understand, but I think you get it. I love it. And we're going to take this one. Yeah. So this is telling you to trust your instincts. Now some of y'all should be really. Trust your instincts. Because they came out together in regards to messages, downloads you may be receiving at this time. In regards to universal love. And when I say that reading that I got the other day. And it was nothing that you can't deny because it was in the cards. You know, even though I pay attention to, you know, my intuition, it was in the cards. Like you couldn't doubt the message. Yeah. You're not alone. Now, some of you guys may actually be fine in feathers. You don't have to. Now, you could even see a feather on TV or something like that. I don't know. But you could be. There's something going on with your crown and your throat. What's all this? And this is the sacral, that color right there. Yeah, healing. Like you're really in balance, boo. And pink does represent the heart. Yeah, we can see 144 here if we really wanted to. If we really wanted to. Now, let's see what's coming out the tarot. Alright. That's making me go for this deck, even though it's one I haven't used in a while. Same cards, different energy. Yeah. That's why. Look at this. 44. Universal love. Some type of offer. You can rest. You really are in balance. This is all about some good news coming your way. Could be traveling, but very optimistic, standing your ground, moving forward, not afraid. Wow. To face this beast head on. Do go check out that reading that I posted on my other channel. That was good, too. Juicy. Juicy, juicy. I got all your signs up there. I think I did. What did I stop out with? I put them all up there. But I'm with, what did I start with? I know I got them all up there and I started all over again. I think I'm at Cancer. But I got them all up there and I'm doing it again. Yeah. I know I'm being a little bit more consistent. Ooh, look what Spirit bringing in regards to your broken heart, boo. Yeah, that's the end to that. And look what you got. I guess she wants you to see the big picture. Love and partnership. It came out with the Ace of Pentacles though, in healing. Yeah. I guess it wanted to be next to that. Okay. Good news. Completion. Now the King of Wands. Looking at this Eight of Pentacles. It's like something is ready. He's looking at that ace from both sides. Now, this could be two people coming together. Because he is under the King of Wands. It's under the High Priestess. And it's just energy. You know? Alright, these cards. No, they old. And then we got the 7 and the, yeah, the 10. 10, 10. Yeah, I do see, you know, your family, somebody, whatever this is, got your back. I know that. Something is coming into balance. And I think you are the generational curse breaker. This is the goal for your family, your legacy. Some type of completion. Yeah. Gifts. Relationships. Beating the devil. Tearing the matrix down. Personal growth, tempering yourself, universal love, right here, moving to smoother waters, some type of new beginning, moving to a wish fulfillment. That wish fulfillment is, this 8 is right on the Ace of Pentacles. This is you. Somebody taking a leap of faith in regards to a relationship as well. Yeah, they're going to offer. You're moving away from sadness. Somebody is coming up out of that situation too. You got that cup. And if that's what you've been manifesting in, it's coming your way, boo. That was that tower. Helping you to let go. Yeah, completion. Letting go, coming into balance. This is letting go, completion of things that whoever this was holding on to. Now, I do see finances coming into balance. Maybe being able to save a little something, something, something for a rainy day. Spirit, I'm telling you. Think of the wish fulfillment. Right there on the family. Ah. Look at all those cups. Somebody gonna be crying their little tail off. Look at all that happiness. It's happiness. This is truth and clarity. In abundance. Look at the ace. Look at the wedding bells. That's what you want. There's always 3 cards. Yeah, personal growth. Thank God. And the world card. Look at that. All of that right there. Taming that little ego. This is the right there on universal. The world card. Boom. If that ain't clear, I don't know what it is. And this is all the tangible things that you could ever want. Look, it's all there. Relationships, jobs, promotion, money. Standing up for yourself. And that's what you got to continue to do. Don't let nothing control your mind, boo. Because it's protected. You protect it. With the truth. Yep. Because you took that little journey. You know, I love to see this card as self-discovery. Because this is what he's holding. Yeah. It's coming, darling. It is coming. Now we're going to pull one card for you. Let's see what's going on. You got two. All right. You got two. Is a pretty card too. So recently you let go of some distractions in your life and everything has upgraded since. You realize that holding on to things, food, stimulants, or people only keep you anchored to the physical world. Truth lies in letting go of all that is not you. The daily coffee, pieces of chocolate, social media addictions, or a need to buy. Those were once such a part of your identity, but have now diminished. This is the time to go deeper into Fatara and let go of any attachments, even those that are less obvious. Continue to meditate, which draws you immediately into your Fatara and illuminates what is it that you're holding on to. It says, it is only from here that you can listen to the truth within and act accordingly. And of course, everything done in moderation. I know they say you let go of a lot, but that doesn't necessarily mean that this isn't so. Okay, boo? Now, the reverse says, this is a time to retreat and draw back into yourself, letting go of any clutches you've used in the past to make you feel good. Chocolate, coffee, social media, or TV shows. You know, it says Fatara translates as to withdraw oneself from which nourishes the senses, Through releasing attachments to successorial distractions, we move closer to self-realization and eventually inner peace. What have you been holding on to distract yourself? Perhaps it's food or material possessions or surrounding yourself with people. Let go of all that no longer serves you so that you can know who you are, basically. Now, I want to say, ain't nobody out here perfect. Easy does it, you know. Don't beat yourself up if you eat a piece of chocolate or drink a cup of coffee. You understand what I'm saying? Moderation is the key. Now, I'm gonna just leave it there. Now, I think it's really big when you let go of alcohol and drugs. It's huge. Okay. I'm not beating you up if you do it. That's your demon. Alright. Now, this card says, Pitta, the fire of the water are the two most powerful elements that can create and destroy anything. Together they create Pitta, which is empowering you today. You are at a determined place in your life. You know what you want, and the fire has been set up under your seat to achieve it. You are setting goals for yourself and focus on the task at hand. Perhaps this is time to emerge as a leader and teach others your strength and wisdom. You are transforming the world with your action. Just don't lose connection with the water within you, and remember to play. Yeah. And that's why he came out as the wand, the high priestess. Now, it do look like you're in balance. Look like you're tempering yourself. You can see how you're pouring in that cup. This is on personal growth. You know, don't beat yourself up if you still need, got things that you need to let go of. Ain't nobody gonna never be perfect, but you know, it's just for you to recognize and know it's those areas that you still need to work on. Okay? Yeah. Because I got a big one. Somebody said my cigar was gone out of the mouth. I smoked it. I need to, I got to get another one. I had dropped my thing in the toilet, y'all. And it was at night, so I couldn't get to the store, so I had to smoke it. All right. See you later, y'all. Hit the like button.